All right. So Barry, in a nutshell, describe what the plea agreement is here today.
That there was a reduction to from a felony to an A misdemeanor with the agreement that he would not be incarcerated, have no probation, be granted a conditional discharge of 1 year, and then the matter's over at that point in exchange for his resignation.
So he did resign from the force, the judge took that into account. I mean,
correct.
How big is that? Some may say, oh, this guy avoided jail time, but what does it mean to him to resign from the force in this way?
Well, he always, this was his life. He's a greatly commended police officer. He's received at least 9 commendations. He's on the SWAT team. He's a former Marine. He was in charge of Marine One. So this was his life, was being a police officer and helping the community and giving back to the community, protecting the community. So it was something that he did not want to have happen. But we did offer the resignation. He is now not a felon. This was reduced to a misdemeanor. As I said, no jail time, no probation. So it's just a conditional discharge.
What was the couple trying to avoid? What was the point of lying?
Well, they made a mistake, and they've taken responsibility. He's taken responsibility for the mistake. And he is a decorated police officer, former veteran in the Marine Corps. So he has acknowledged the mistake, and it's time to move on.
Is he in any way precluded from trying to be an officer somewhere else?
That's a labor or law question. I'm not familiar with what the answer would be.
Does he want to try to get a job at another police department, do you know?
I would think he would want to be a police officer again if he could, because serving his community is who he is. So thank you.
Jim?